You know, everyone kind of breaks off and does their own stuff throughout the day. Matt usually gets a little bit of his jiu-jitsu in early in the day.
And hopefully either have a jiu-jitsu partner coming out. Like today I had one of my coaches, John Simons. He's Five Finger Death Punch's head of security, but he's also a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt. So he trained me for a little bit today. He's coming out tomorrow as well. If not him, then one of my other friends or coaches from around the country or around the world, or one of my three guys, my guitar tech, sound guy, tour manager, or drummer, Matt. 10x10 mats that usually goes underneath the tent because it's usually hot as heck outside. We have all our gis and all that stuff. We got like four or five gis with us and backup rash guards, all this stuff that everyone can train with.
It's a good sport for guitar players.
Yeah, it's really good. I recommend it.
And singers.
Just look at my hands.
And if I'm really bored, I usually just go over to our merch tent and just kind of hang out there, do kind of like a unofficial meet and greet. Since we're not doing any signings on this tour, I'll just kind of chill there. I'll sell merch. People won't even know it's me selling it sometimes, and I'll just kind of just hang out with our merch dude, Eric.
Eric, our merch guy right here.
What's up? Yeah. Basically, I stand out here all day, sell to these crazy people, some nice folks, some kind of rough, and basically, yeah, set up, tear down.
Checking at like 8 in the morning?
Yeah, about a 17-hour day, give or take. That's about it.
This is our tour manager, sound guy, production manager, fellow sometimes jiu-jitsuer with Matt. Kind of the guy we call up, you know, when we're stranded somewhere, drunk, need a ride, need to figure out how to get back to the bus. He's the first guy everyone texts when things start going wrong. Everything.
And everything's my fault,
yeah.
Good or bad. I couldn't be happier with these guys. Everyone does their own thing. We do things together. You know, it's a good time.
Pretty easy going out here.
Every day around 3 o'clock or so, we start staging the drums, staging on the back line. Korn and Avenge are also doing the same thing. We just come here, I still set up all this stuff. We just get everything ready for the show. I still do drum tech myself. I prefer to do it myself. I'm so used to drum teching with Nick previously and Jordan with As I Dying that I just got comfortable with it and kind of pretty picky, so I like everything to be just right. A lot of people say I'm a perfectionist, but it comes with the trades. I still do it all myself. It makes me feel comfortable for the show, knowing that everything's right where I need it to. I have all my marks laid out all over the drum carpet here, and it's a comforting thing for me to be able to hop up in front of the fans and have it, you know, ready to go.
Well, we don't have a ton of production here since we're opening the main stage. There's a lot of gear, so we have this made at like the end of In Waves, just sort of a giant T mirror statue thing, and it's pretty heavy duty. And we actually now we're using this company in Germany called All Your Band Needs, and they made all our set for In Waves over in Europe. We've got all our gear, it's all set. Just put the lid on these, check it right onto a plane, and you know, for us it's about having consistency every single day, and it's been a lifesaver for us. It's our guitar tech Jeremy over here, Jeremy Frost.
Hello.
Handles all our rigs, our guitars right here. Got my Warlock, Corey's Jackson's, Matt's Epiphones. And we just kind of want to make sure it flows quickly. There's not too many changes, not too much downtime. We just keep things rolling.
3 hours before the show, I do vocal warm-ups for an hour straight with Ron Anderson's warm-ups. It's my vocal teacher's app, Ron Anderson. It's his voice app. Like, I always record my lessons with him, but I like just cycling through his exercises. Like, I'll do all of them. It usually takes about 30 minutes, and then pick the ones I feel like I need to really work on. And you'll notice I'm kind of doing placement, because Ron's been teaching. For certain higher notes, you should have your jaw lower, like here, and your mouth open. When you do the higher notes, it just helps resonate better. I used to just think I was a really low singer, but it turns out I've got a much higher range than I thought. But it's just not strong enough yet to use it functionally in Trivium, so I'm just working on it every day. That's why I sing for such a long period of time, like an hour a day, just to make sure it's getting strong on my way up. Eye drops, I had LASIK recently, so I gotta do that a lot. Lip balm, just because. Two vocal things that I like. Slippery Elm is really good for your voice. Neomed, I use this twice a day. It's like a natural, it's kind of like a neti pot, but a little more forceful. Allergy medicine, just to keep, this is for voice and nose, and then brush my teeth. This time make my hair beautiful for stage. I do that, and as soon as my warm-ups are done, I don't speak again to the show. Immediately after vocal warm-ups, guitar warm-ups for 15 to 30 minutes, metronome, and just do a bunch of John Petrucci exercises.
Usually on average, pick up a guitar and start warming up around like 4:30. Most of the times it's just kind of pick up and just kind of play whatever I feel like at the time. And then here, Matt, his warm-up routine is the exact opposite. Every time he starts warming up for a show, he plays the exact same warm-up routine.
The Petrucci ones.
Yeah, it's a John Petrucci rock discipline warm-up exercises. He plays those in order of the warm-up sequence on the DVD every single day, has the exact same warm-up routine, like everything's scheduled exactly, and then the rest of us just kind of just start a warm-up whenever you kind of earn the mood to. So it's like kind of opposites on the bus as far as show prep.
It's a throw and go for me every day, so I get about 30 seconds to, if I'm lucky,
running paradiddles.
10 minutes, yeah, paradiddles. Kind of get all the muscles in my arm ready to go, just blood flowing.
Throw and go on the plane, but spend at least 15 minutes getting that hair ready.
Yeah. The hair, yeah. It gets messed up, and then I gotta do it again, and then again.
You gotta get one of those, like, look like the switchblade knife, but it's the Hulk comb.
Yeah.
That would actually be sweet.
Like, greasy.
Use it on stage, too.
Up, like, get done a song. You gotta stand up, too, while you do it. Stand up, comb the hair, sit back down.
After that, 15 to 30 minutes of yoga, Ashtanga yoga.
About an hour before, 5:20, 5:30, start warming up vocals. Warming up bass, stretching, get changed.
What people think of a band, like the exact opposite. Like people think of dudes that are late for everything, or never ready, aren't fit, they don't clean shit, or like ready too early. Warm up too much.
Mike, our monitor engineer extraordinaire.
Hello.
Make sure all our in-ears sound good. These little things right here. It's a lot, probably gotta be one of the hardest things to do in the crew, I think. But we're all so particular about what we want to hear and stuff, so there's a lot that goes into it. He just lets us know when we gotta get up there, when we're gonna do Run to the Hills. He gives us the countdown.
Paula doesn't like his in-ear mix and throws his face out.
Yeah, just throw it straight at his face.
We start running Run to the Hills, kind of our pre-show song that lets people know out there it's time to start making your way to the main stage, get ready for the show.
It's showtime! That's where we are, that's where we fight, that's where they die, the battle!
Yeah.
just finished. I was gonna bow like normal, and then I see Head from Korn running up and hands me this. That was pretty crazy. Because each one of those guys, like Monkey, was asking about my guitar, so he was just asking about it, but I got him one because they're the reason why I started playing seven strings. And Head was kind of jealous when he saw it. He's kidding around. He's like, "Oh, where's mine?" And I surprised him with one, and then Jonathan asked for one, so I couldn't refuse one of my favorite bands in the world wanting my guitar. So then he gave me one of his.
Finished the set, had a great show, took a shower, and now it's time for post-show dinner, which Apollo and I usually, they have catering on site, but we kind of prefer to just make our own stuff, so we do Walmart stops and buy like lots of canned chicken and stuff like that, so.
See where the night goes from there. Sometimes I'll go watch Korn or Avenged.
Having Head back, it's unbelievable, man. Like, they could have no production on stage and be, I think, one of the best live bands there is. So many good bands on this bill.
Oh, we're just hanging out, having some drinks, watching the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
Thank you for just being my
Ragers
brother.
Ragers we are.
And making sure your baby brother was
listen
okay.
To speeches.
Love you, man.
Nothing pumps Corey up like a fucking football. My baby
Hall of Fame speeches gets me raging.
Thank you. Brother, I just called
Corey watches calls. Rudy before you go on every day.
I'm always
Rudy. He's just let your soul glow.
You hit it. You hit it.
It's the only time it can be done.
That was good.
Just let your soul glow.
What's that movie?
Coming to America.
Thank you guys for spending a day in the life with Trivium. We had a lot of fun showing you the whole entire day. Matt stretching. Matt setting up his kit. Corey drinking vodka. Me riding around on my bike. And I hope you enjoyed it. We had a lot of fun. See you next time.
The next part's just for us.